ISUPK.
Practical knowledge started out of 1 West 125th Street, all of New York, under Commanding General Yohanna. We are not affiliated with any other Israelite group out there, man. We come out here to teach that blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the real Jews according to the Bible. The real Jews, not those imposters that inhabit the land of Israel right now. Those are not the real Jews. The real Jews according to the Bible that everybody claims to follow are black, Hispanic, and Native American. And guess what? The Bible also says the white man is the devil, the Bible speaks of. That's in the Bible. That's in the Bible. I know Christian church will tell you God loves everybody. The Christian church will tell you we got to love. We got to kill them with kindness. God loves everybody. That's not in the Bible. The Christian church does not teach the Bible. The Christian church does not love God. They don't follow Christ. They don't do anything the Bible says. Because in the Bible, it says blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the real Jews, and he hates the white man. Matter of fact, give me Romans 9 and 13. God hates the white man. We're not saying it because we hate him. We do, but we hate him because God hates him. And God hates him because of the things he has done to blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You don't believe me? It's Hispanic children in cages right now. It's Hispanic children drinking out of toilets right now. But you want to tell us to celebrate the 4th of July. We're supposed to be happy about how we live in America. But yet you got the Native Americans have the highest suicide rate living in hell on the reservations. 350,000 black babies are killed every year. But yet you want us to be happy and celebrate the 4th of July. And we're supposed to be proud Americans. Damn that. Damn that. Guess what? God hates the white man and he hates America. You know why? Because what he has done to our people. Look, the white man hears that, and he feels no guilt or shame about it, man. He's so arrogant in his lust for murder, he doesn't feel anything wrong with Hispanic children, innocent children, being in cages. The white man got more love for damn puppies than he do to Hispanic children. The white man is a beast. The white man is a cancer upon the face of the earth. And God hates the white man. And we're going to bring it out in the Bible. Because this is what the Bible says. We're not saying it because we said it. It's the Bible. We read the Bible. We follow the Bible back here, man. Right. Tell them where you at.
Romans chapter 9, verse 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
As it is written. You know where it's written? I just said it. He's reading from it. It's in the damn Bible. As it is written, it says, Jacob have I loved. Anybody know who Jacob is? Any Bible scholars out there? You know, white people love to claim that. I went to theology school. I'm a scholar. No, the hell you ain't. This Bible is a black man's book, written by black men, for black men. You know why? Because we need it. We need a set of morals and laws. We need to know who we are. We don't know who we are in America. That's why a lot of black people, a lot of our people, yesterday was popping off fireworks, having cookouts, having barbecues, when that holiday has nothing to do with our people. It has nothing to do with our people. Thank you. How that, just know, it has nothing to do with our people, man. We are slaves in America still. And during July 4th, 1776, we were in the cotton fields still. We were still in the cotton fields. Our women were still being raped. We were still being beat. Our children were still being stolen from their parents, just like they do now at the damn border. Nothing has changed. The white man has been a devil then. The white man is a devil now. And he will keep on being a devil, man. Right, the water cap. Now he's an independent devil. That's all. Right. Before, he's a devil from the English colony. Now he's an independent devil. Let me tell you something. The white man is such a devil, he couldn't deal with his own devils. He had to get it from underneath the British. Because he knows how much of a devil and how much a white man oppresses people. That's why he had to get it freed from the British. That's why you had July 4th, 1776. The bombs bursting in air and all that trash, man. It's garbage. That's right. Nothing to do with black people, man.
That's right.
Goddamn the white man's holidays. Goddamn the white man's independence.
That's
we
right.
Still in slavery here in America, man.
Right.
Just because they took the chains off don't mean we're free.
Right.
Doesn't mean we're free, but guess what? This is why God hates the white man. And this is in the Bible. We're bringing it out. Start from the top.
Romans chapter 9, verse 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
Jacob have I loved. Jacob is the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel. His name was changed to Israel. That's why we're called Israelite. Jacob is it will be our great, 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 all the way back grandfather for blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. I guess you, I bet we didn't know all this time our lineage has been right here in the Bible. We go to Ancestry.com and 23andMe and all these DNA sites that lie. They lied to us. Them DNA tests don't tell you who we really are. Guess what? Our DNA and our lineage and our history and our constitution, our laws have been right here this whole time in front of our face. And we never knew it. It's in the Bible. And right here it says, Jacob have I loved. Black man, Hispanic man, Native American, we come from Jacob. And guess what? That means God loves you. I know the white man will make it think how much he oppresses us that God does not love us. Guess what? The fact that we're in hell lets you know that God loves us because he's disciplining us for being disobedient. But that's a different topic. Listen, God loves us. Read on.
But Esau.
But who?
But Esau.
But who?
Esau.
Esau is the progenitor of the so-called white man. Listen, let me tell you something. The white man is not white. He's not white. That's white supremacy brainwashing. They call themselves white because we associate innocence and purity and everything good with white. Guess what? Well, guess what the white man really is? Look at him. Look at him. He's red. When Africans, when the white man gets mad, look at his skin. When he gets embarrassed, he turns red. When you hit him, he turns purple and yellow. They're the real colored man, but guess what? That's who they come from. Esau. Esau's the progenitor of the white man. And this is what the Bible says about the white man.
But Esau have I hated.
But Esau have I what?
Have I hated.
Have I what?
Have I hated.
Spell that word for him, because listen, this is for all the Christians out there. That God is all love. God is all love. Stop lying to the people, Christian pastors. God is not all love, because right here it says, Jacob have I loved. Esau have I what?
Esau have I hated. Hated. H-A-T-E-D.
Hated. Hated. That's what it says. The Bible says, God hates the white man. Deal with that. God hates the white man. So why are we still trying to love the white man and give love to him? Why are we still doing that? We have more hate and animosity towards our own people than we do to the people that's destroying us right before our eyes. Right before our eyes. We come out here to get high. We come out here to sleep with whores and steal and rob. You know why? Because the white man is such a devil. That's not our culture. That's not our culture. None of that comes from us. That's not our culture. Guess what? The white man is the biggest thug. The white man is the biggest murderer. The white man is the biggest criminal on the face of the earth. And that's not me saying it. That's history. You can look at history, and history will tell you the white man is the goddamn devil. Am I lying? Ask a Native American. Ask him. I'll tell you what. Let's call a Native American right here, and let's ask him who the white man is. Good luck trying to find one. Good luck trying to find one. You know why? Because the white man just damn near wiped out all the Native Americans. They killed 77 million Native Americans. You know how? Through smallpox, through syphilis. Through killing all the buffalo, through stealing their land, the Trail of Tears. They wanted to celebrate the 4th of July when their presidents have a history of oppressing our people. Andrew Jackson initiated the Trail of Tears, which destroyed so many of our Native American brothers. But yet we want to love the white man when God hates the white man. God hates the white man. Read from the top. This is all the Christians. God loves you, black man, Hispanic man, Native American, Indian man. And it's in the Bible. It's right here. Read.
Romans chapter 9, verse 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
Black man, Hispanic man, Native American, Indian man, God loves you. Why are we getting mad to hear that God loves us? The whole world hates us. The Africans hate us. The Chinese hate us. The East Indians hate us. Everybody comes to America and shows us how much they don't give a damn about black people. Everybody comes in our neighborhoods to make money off our people. Yet they speak, no, they don't say anything about the problems that we go through being oppressed. Where's all the Chinese men that own the nail salons and the hair shops? Why aren't they speaking up when our sisters are being oppressed? Why aren't they speaking up when black people are being killed? Why aren't anybody else speaking up about the Hispanics being in cages? You know why? Because the whole world hates black people. The whole world hates black people. And guess what? The brother said the IHBK are the only people speaking about the problems that the white man has done to our people, man, and continue to do to our people. We are the only people. We are the last hope. We are the last hope. And listen, I thought it was no hope too. I know we're so oppressed, we don't think it's hope or anything because the white man is such a devil and it looks like he can never be beat or destroyed. Lies. Lies. Guess what? Come back here and learn how to change your life. It's not about fighting the white man physically. We got to change out. We got to stop smoking. We got to stop being homosexuals. Stop being murderers and drug dealers and rapists and child molesters, man. None of that is our culture. We learned that from following after the goddamn devil, the white man. The white man has a culture of molesting kids, aka the Catholic Church. So why are you surprised that the Christian Church doesn't do the same thing? The Christian Church comes from the Catholic Church. So that's why a lot of our people are, listen, you don't have to talk about it, but a lot of us already know, a lot of our people are molested right in the damn church and live with that pain all their life and never talk about it. You know why? Because that's white culture. Christianity is white supremacy. To be a Christian, you saying, I love the white man. And guess what? How about this? Everybody want to talk about Donald Trump this. Donald Trump is a Christian. Donald Trump is a good Christian. And guess what? If you're a Christian, you believe the same thing Donald Trump believes. If you are a Christian, you love Donald Trump. So I don't want to hear that garbage about Trump this and Trump that, but you go to church, man. Come out of them churches, man. Come out of them Roman, come out of them, what's it called? The Catholic, come out of the Catholic Church, the one. Come out the mosque, come out of all of that, man. That has nothing to do with our people. Come, well, come. Read it from the top one more time.
Romans chapter 9, verse 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
But Esau have I hated. Now, I know I said Esau's a terror, the white man, right? I know it's hard to believe, so we're going to get in the Bible, because everything we say we prove. Give me Genesis 25 and 25. It's in the Bible, man. The Bible describes the white man in the Bible. It describes him being the devil. It describes him being the wicked, the deviant, the predator upon the face of the earth. We think the white man is so innocent, man. He's a thug and a criminal and should not ever be trusted, man. Can't you tell? Look how we live, man. Look how we live everywhere in America. Every ghetto across the country, black, Hispanics, and Native Americans live in the same conditions. Utmost poverty. We live in poverty wherever we are. While the white man lives deliciously. While the Chinese have Chinatown. While the East Indians have whatever they have. And the Africans, you know, the Africans stick to themselves. Don't nobody want to be around a stinking African. But listen, everybody come over here and capitalizes on black people because they are under the white, they follow the white man and him being the devil, man. They hate all of us, and guess what? God hates the white man. That's something we should take pride, be happy in knowing. The world hates us, but God loves us, man, and he hates the white man. But this is who Esau is according to the Bible. This is who he is. The Bible is describing the white man right here. Tell him where you at.
Genesis chapter 25, verse 25. And the first came out red.
And the first came out red. Now this is describing the birth of two babies right now. This is describing the birth, Isaac and Rebekah. Isaac is the son of Abraham. I know we always hear Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, right? Isaac is Abraham's son, and this is describing the birth of Isaac's two sons, right here.
And the first came out red.
And the first came out what?
Red.
Red, R-E-D, rojo, red. He first came out red, right? So the reason why it's describing his color, because it's telling you right here, everybody else in the Bible that's mentioned were not this color. Why would you have to describe something if everybody was already that? It's describing his color because everybody in the Bible is black. But this particular baby right here, this baby came out red. Read on.
All over like a hairy garment.
All over like a hairy garment. So not only was this baby red, this baby was hairy. Like a garment, man. Like a garment. Now let me tell you this right here. Anybody that's gonna be truthful about it, what race of people that you know are red and hairy? Anybody gonna tell the truth about it? What race of people are red and hairy? Naturally. The white man, I just gave it to you, took too long. The white man is the devil. He's red and hairy. If the white man goes 1 month without shaving, I'm telling you, he'd be a caveman. You see his arms, you see the hairs on top of his collar, you see his face. They grow hair so fast, they're hairy, man. They are cavemen, they're Neanderthals, man. And the Bible's saying it right here, he was red and hairy. This is the firstborn child, right? The white man, the red and hairy one. Read on.
And they called his name Esau.
And the red and hairy baby's name was Esau. So right here, this is giving us history. The white man's great-great-great-great-great-grandfather, his name was Esau. That's who the white man comes from. That's who he comes from. That's his lineage. Read on.
Verse 26. And after that came his brother out, and his hand took hold on Esau's
hand. That's it, drop that. And after that was born Jacob, who black people come from. That's where we come from. But the white man in the Bible is described as being red and hairy. You know, before 1462 or 92, Christopher Columbus came to America. Before that, we weren't calling a white man white. We weren't calling him white. That's something recent in recent history, because it's white supremacy. If you read in the dictionary, read the definition of white. And what is it? All the things it's going to say, we associate it with goodness, with purity, with innocence, with kindness. That's what we associate with white. That's why the white man calls himself white. When we see clearly, look at him. They are not white. They're the same color as a pig, man. They are the same color as a pig. I'm not making it up. Look at him. Look at him. And some of them is darker red. But that's who the white man is according to the Bible. And it says it right here. It says it right here. The white man is the devil, according to the Bible. Guess what? We just read in Romans 9 and 13, God hates the white man. Give me Obadiah 1 and 10. God hates the white man. You know why? Because black people are hooked on drugs. Because our little black kids don't know to be gay or not. Because black kids are being molested and stolen. You know, the DMV has the highest rate of black women going missing in the whole damn country. Why is anybody talking about that? Our black women are being kidnapped, our children are being molested and put into cages at the border. Black men are being incarcerated like crazy. Baltimore, right up the street, they just had a video come out. The officer planting drugs with a brother in Baltimore, man. They do it in DC too. But DC, they're a little more slick, so they don't get caught up on the cameras. But they do it too, man. All over the world, we are oppressed by the white man. Not just us. Listen, we don't give a damn about nobody but blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, but look, the whole earth is oppressed by the white man, man. The whole earth. We think just because they do business with the white man that they love him. Let me tell you something. They hate the white man. They hate the Japanese. You think they forgot about Hiroshima and Nagasaki? You think those people forgot about their ancestors that got killed by an atom bomb? You think the Afghanis forgot about 9/11 and 2003 and the Iraqis forgot about that? Nah, man. We're the only people that forget about the crimes done to our people and turn right around and open our arms to the white man like, come on, hug it out, brother, hug it out. I love you in spite of, I love you anyways. Bring it in, that's right there, bring it in, bring it in. Damn that, damn that, man. The white man is the devil and we have to stop loving him. You know why? Because don't we need love? Look at our people, don't we need love? When the last time a black man told another black man, and not a homosexual white man, I'm looking out for you, man. I hope you make it. I love you, brother. When the last time a black woman told another black woman, I love you, sister, man. I hope you're doing good. How the kids doing? When the last time we've been like that towards each other, man? Can't nobody even say remember, because guess what? We so busy hating each other, and we turn right back around and give our love to the same people that's destroying us, the white man. Right, and guess what? We was giving them all our love last night. You know how? Popping off them fireworks, having them damn cookouts for a holiday that didn't have nothing to do with us, man. Like, people been saying this, it's common knowledge. People been saying this for so long. We were not free July 4th, 1776. What do we not understand about that? We were not free. So what are you celebrating? I seen a lot of brothers, a lot of coons had on red, white, and blue outfits, American outfits, two pieces, with the flags and hats, man. You look silly, man. You look silly, man, because that's not our culture, man. Stop following after the damn white man. You know we become following after the white man? Murderers. Murderers and rapists and homosexuals and liars and child molesters. That's what we become, following after the white man. And that's not our culture, man. Tell them where you at.
Obadiah, chapter 1, verse 10. For thy violence.
For thy what?
Thy violence.
Thy what?
Violence.
For thy violence. This is why God hates the white man. Not because of that pink skin, not because of those blue eyes, but why?
For thy violence.
For thy violence. Violence against who? The Bible's gonna tell you. Read on.
For thy violence against thy brother Jacob.
Now we just had the history lesson real quick. Jacob will be our great-great-great-grandfather. That's who we come from. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And it's saying, God hates the white man for his violence against blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You know, the white man came over here and took our babies from our mothers and used them for alligator bait, man. They used our babies for alligator bait. They cut out the skin of black men and used it for leather wallets and leather shoes, man. But this is not us making this up. This is history. History that we don't learn in their damn public schools. But guess what? They want to teach us that the slave trade was a migration. And you know, come on, man, they're teaching us trash in them schools. They don't teach us the real history of how much the devil has been to our people, man. The white man has been a complete devil to blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And guess what? Has anything changed? Has anything changed?
No.
No, sis, we still in poverty. We still gotta work 16 hours and come home to rats and roaches. We still gotta ride the bus trying to figure out how we gonna get to the next job. We're not even enough bus fare, man. We still trying to, man, listen, man, the white man's a devil, man. And it makes me so angry that we cannot see that by now.
That's right.
It makes me so angry, and you should be angry, man. That's why the white man flooded our communities with drugs,
yes,
to keep us distracted,
yes,
and not be angry.
Killing one another.
That's what the white man has done. So we can kill each other and give, and listen, they did that, and we still turn around and love them. We still turn around and get high. When the reason why the drugs are in our community is because of a government conspiracy, man.
They allow it.
The white man thinks we love to get high and we deserve to live how we live, when the white man is the one that's putting all the drugs in the community.
Yes, right.
The white man is the one putting the guns in the community.
Yes. Right.
The white man is the ones killing our children, man.
Yes.
The white man is a devil, and then he turns right back around. You know what the white man is like? The white man is, let me tell you, this is how it is. Black people and our relationship with white people. We are like a child to the white man. And guess what? It's like you got a cookie jar, right? And the parent tells their child, don't eat no cookies out that cookie jar. The white man will be the parent, right? The white man will do this. The white man will go into the cookie jar, eat all the cookies, and then come whoop the child for the cookies that he ate. That's how wicked the white man is. The white man creates a problem and it turns right back around and blames the problem on us. You think it's by chance that we drug addicts?
No.
Listen, the truth is coming out now. Guess who hooking them opiates? Guess who dying every day in staggering numbers off the opiates?
We are.
We've been dying, but guess who dying now? These white people. Because now the truth is coming out. They've always been drug addicts. They've always been deviants and murderers. Thank God for the cell phones, because now we get to see what's always been happening when the police stop black men, man. We get to see how much of a devil they are. How can you deny what you see? Come on, ain't that what you need? Come. Tell them where you at.
Obadiah, chapter 1, verse 10. For thy violence against thy brother, Jacob, shame shall cover thee.
Shame shall cover thee, man. Shame shall cover thee. When we talk about the crimes, because we the only ones to talk about what's going on with our people. When we bring out the crimes of the white man, they walk by and they don't want to hear. You know what I'm saying? Because it's the first time in their life they feel some ounce of shame.
Right.
They may not show it because they do that ugly smile that they do. Oh, hey, how's it going? But they feel shame because they know, like, damn, I am a devil. Look at how they treat our people, man. They are devils. Read it again.
Verse 10, for thy violence against thy brother Jacob, shame shall cover thee.
Shame shall cover thee. Guess what? That's why they don't want to pay reparations. You know why? Because they will have to be ashamed to know we've did this to you people.
Right.
To pay reparations is to admit they have done wrong.
Right.
To admit you have done wrong causes shame.
Right.
And the white man doesn't want to be shamed. And that's what the Bible says, what?
Shame for thy violence against thy brother, Jacob, shame shall cover thee.
They were violent towards us, man. The white man was violent to those slaves they brought over here, man. In 1776, July 4th, 1776, the white man was violent.
Right.
And still violent. And guess what? Shame shall cover thee. That's why they can't pay the reparations. They cannot.
Right.
Black man, understand this. We are never going to get reparations from the white man. You know why? Because that is an admission of guilt.
That's right.
You know what that's like? If you do a crime and you have to pay restitution. Restitution is saying you have committed the crime. Right. The water. It's like in D.C. Paying the ticket in D.C. is saying you admitting to the guilt. You know what I'm saying? The white man can't pay this ticket. He can't pay the ticket for the violence against blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. The white man is violent. Read it again, man. Read it again. The Bible talks about the white man being a devil. But we claim to love the Bible and love God, but the Christian pastors aren't teaching us what it really says, man. This is what it said.
Verse 10. For thy violence against thy brother Jacob.
No sweat.
For thy violence against thy brother Jacob, shame shall cover thee. And thou shalt be cut off forever.
And thou shalt be cut off forever. Guess what? I know it looks like our oppression will never end, right? I know it looks like there's no hope and there's nothing we can look forward to. Guess what? A black man who the world knows as Christ is coming back with 200 million black angels and he's going to destroy America, man. It's going to happen. I know it sounds like this is some sci-fi type stuff. No, this is real. It's going to happen. You know why? Because unless America is destroyed, we will be in poverty for the rest of eternity, man.
Right.
Unless America is destroyed, our women will continue to abort our babies, man. Unless America is destroyed, black people will, the whole black race, our little children will be homosexuals, man. Unless America is destroyed, our children will continue to be raped and molested in these churches.
That's right.
So America has to be destroyed by the hands of Christ, man. So that we can come out of this poverty, and come out of these terrible conditions we are in. Give me Proverbs 29:2. We're gonna bring it out, man. We're gonna bring it up. Can anybody deny that we living in hell?
Oh, we hell right here.
That's right, sis. Damn right. This is her hand. She already know. We in hell right here.
That's right.
And they in heaven. The Christian church teaches you heaven is a place in the sky with clouds and little naked white babies. And hell is some place with a man with a pitchfork underneath the ground. No. According to the Bible, hell is a condition. Just like heaven is a condition. And guess what? What's our current condition in America? Hell. Are we in heaven? No, we ain't in heaven, man. Come on, man. Any black person that says we in heaven is lying and is brainwashed by the white supremacy lies. The white man is in heaven. The white man is in heaven. Look, he can go anywhere he wants comfortably and do what he wants. Listen, we see the videos of, Barbecue Becky and all the white women that call the police on black men or black women for no reason. They can go wherever they want and do whatever they want. And guess what? And nothing happens because this is their heaven. This is their heaven. The police are here for them. They know when they call the police is coming to protect them.
Right.
Black woman, you call the police, you're not even sure if you're gonna make it out alive. You could be the one in the right, and they'll come and lock you up. They'll come and beat your child. Because it's not our heaven. We are in hell. This is what the Bible says, man.
We want